Hey guys, and welcome back to the next episode of Tiger's Tour Top. I don't know what episode this is, to be honest. I just finished recording the last episode, yesterday's episode, and now another episode. So the things I want to talk about are, first of all, I want to make a quick review of the season, what I think about it, what I think is going to happen in Season 3, what I want to do before Season 3. That's the first thing I want to talk about. Then I want to talk about what happened around the world, so basically who scored the most goals in the season, who was the biggest transfer, which team made the biggest improvements and stuff, who got the Ballon d'Or, who won the Champions League, and this kind of stuff. And then last but not least, I want to talk about one important topic. First of all, what do I think about this season? It was exactly like last season, and the problem for me is this: we have one huge bad one and one huge good one. I mean, last season I think we had a run of like 8 wins in a row and a total like 11 or 12 games unbeaten, the best one ever in the history of this club. And straight afterwards, so really it's ended, and then straight away we had the worst run in the history of this club. So after the best, the worst, I think we had 13 games without even winning once. And we were doing amazingly, had a decent start, like the first 5-6 games, then it started. We were really close to the playoffs. In the end, we were even almost at the relegation zone again. We had it quite decent from the end, so it was, I think, in the end also, we were close to getting 11th or 10th place, and I think in the end we were 14th or 15th, or maybe even 13th, something like this. We can actually check last season, we were, 15th in the end. This season, the same thing, it was horrible, and then amazing. And I'm not sure what to basically think about it, because I still don't know, is this team normally a bad team who can do amazing sometimes but still is a bad team, or is it actually an amazing team? So I don't know if we are, for example, 13th place, if that's a decent result or bad result. If you could say we can do so amazing, I myself make mistakes and that's why we don't get in the playoffs, which we should be able to, or if it's we actually have amazing ones who save us to not get relegated. I mean, in the end, we have one of the worst teams in the league, and that's why the board always just asks me to avoid relegation. And it's very happy if I can get like 13th, 14th place. It's extremely happy with it. So, still, something I don't 100% understand, but what I think actually that starting next season, we definitely should at least fight for the playoffs. What do I want to do? There are a lot of players I want to get out, with decreasing potential, who played not play good enough, who were not able to win basically the battles against some other players I signed, and for the under 23s, whatever, who performed worse and who did not improve enough. So these people I want to get out of my club. I'm very happy that the contract for some players like Knowles or Parker going out, or whatever you say that. So basically they end. So we're happy about that. And I want to sign some new players, of course. There's not many things I want to do. Still looking at maybe a new center back, because I'm still not 100% sure if Hamadi is the center back I want to use. Except of this, I'm basically happy. So there's nothing I really want to change. What I would look for is another striker who performs amazing. I mean, Cox was amazing at the start, but then still, 4 goals, it's not huge. The best goal in the series for me is still his goal, not the goal from Skinner. They were quite close, but I would give Cox just the win for the best goal in the whole season for Gloucester City. So he won that, basically, trophy. Kotwiga, I will see you, but if he performs like in the end, it maybe can grow, then interesting player. Skinner is just amazing. What is Skinner's potential, actually? He has a potential to just, here you can see, I mean, National League, he has not really actually the potential I hoped he would have. But I think there are a few players I could get into the club who have potential to be even get League 2 football. What I really wanted to do is actually sell players. So I saw other YouTubers doing this, and what then happened, that they signed new players with potential, let them play, they grew, and then they got big offers. Yeah, sometimes Kutsi, for some good example, he got an offer for 750k for a player who is not even worth it, not even close, from Sunderland. And this is the kind of stuff I'm talking about. I want to get out of a few players, actually normally for a lot of money. I was hoping that there's a good offer for Day or Kotwiga. I of course would like to keep them. But if there's an offer of 30-40k for Day, I'm very, very, very happy to sell him, and he's worth it. He definitely has the quality to at least play in the National League. But in my opinion, he definitely is good enough to even play for League Two football teams. So quite unhappy there that I don't actually get offers for this place, or Jackson as well. Especially I'm talking about Jackson, Demon, Palmer, Skinner, Kotwiga, and Dale. These are the main players I'm talking about. A bit unhappy about that, to be honest. And yeah, so I'm going to change and get a few new players in. Not changing too much. The tactics, I'm not thinking I'm going to change that, only if I sign new players and they want to play a bit different. But normally it's just working. I don't want to change it. A few backups is what I want to get. So I'm happy with the goalkeeping position as well as the backups. Right back as well. Left back as well. Center backs, maybe. I would love to find a huge center back because of money. So they are all decent, but nobody's like amazing. And there's in the center mid wall, there's nobody. In the cam wall, there are a few players in training, and definitely I'm gonna have a look at them because that's definitely something really interesting for me. And another amazing winger, I mean, Ferrier is a really decent winger. Cohen is okay. So one more amazing winger, maybe a backup striker who's scoring a goal. So there are a few things I want to change, but not too much in the first choice squad, to be honest. And yeah, that's my main thing I'm going to do. I'm going to try to solve the financial problem, trying to solve that somehow. And we will get a lot of money again from our sponsorship and stuff. So maybe we can maybe even get another one, who knows. And yeah, that's basically it. But I don't even want to talk too much about my team. I want to let's first go to the big leagues. Let's start with the BPL. Well, they're just called BPL. I don't know how they're called. Barclays Premier League, maybe? Barclays Premier League. No, I'm not sure. Just Premier League. So, last season winner was Arsenal, actually. They won the league last season. Don't know if I can see the league table from last season, to be honest. I'm very unsure about that. I don't think so, to be honest, but you can see this season it was not Arsenal, but it was actually Manchester United. I look like this more. It was close, just 2 points in front of Tottenham, 2 points in front of Arsenal. Liverpool gets actually full of Champions League, Chelsea not even Champions League football. Man City is just 10th place. They are doing horrible. Newcastle is also doing amazing. Newcastle there, West Brom, what is going on with Man City? They are embarrassing. Stoke also should do better. I don't know what's going on with Everton and especially also with Man City. That's crazy. Man City last season, can I see what they got last season? Last season they got fourth, so they were amazing. Then last season fourth and now sixth. Last season they were actually just sixth place and now tenth. So something is going on with this. They already got a new coach. Wow, what's going on? Can I have a look at that? No, competitions. I want to have a look at their stuff. I don't know how I can see that. I just wanted to see why. Here, managers. Why they sold him, actually. Well, yeah, he actually got sacked. That's crazy, guys. FIFA Club World winners. That's crazy. Champions League winners. So that seems like they won Champions League. I'm not sure. That's crazy. So that's the BPL, basically, for you. Let's go to the Liga BBVA, or however you call that. I'm not sure how you call that, man. Let's go to Spain and let's do it the same way. Spain, clubs, La Liga Santander, okay. Barcelona won last year and are winning again. 1 point in front of Real Madrid. Atletico at third. Valencia doing quite decent actually here. Nothing too crazy, I would say. We really have to talk about here. So let's go to the Bundesliga. I hope, didn't change. Bayern now with 5 wins in a row. Schalke actually was really decent at the start of the season, but then were really horrible. They were in front of Bayern after like 20 games, like really. And then in the last games they lost everything. They even are close to sacking Vines here. Maybe they did it actually already. Did they? No, he's still there, but the form was amazing. I can have a look, schedule. Amazing form. Now, I don't know what point, but here you can see they had 4 losses in a row, adjusted draw. So they had amazing form here basically. 5 games in a row, just losing. They actually got knocked out by Leicester. After they lost 3-0, they got 1-1. They got knocked out by Leicester City. That's crazy. Lost against Dortmund and against Bayern Leverkusen. They lost important games against Sandhausen as well. I don't understand basically why they were able to get in the league. But you can see that there's no way that they have to do anything this league. Hannover also going down again. So basically the two teams who got promoted last year are now going down. Hamburg again saving themselves is crazy. Leipzig doing, Wolfsburg doing shit, Leipzig okay, Gladbach, Bremen, Augsburg, Ingolstadt, Köln. Some crazy stuff here. Bayern is just winning it. Oh, Premier League actually got in front of them. That's crazy. Let's go to Ligue 1. I don't expect anything else than, of course, PSG winning every time. So let's start then at EuroLeague, at the international thing. So EuroLeague, UEFA EuroLeague. Fenerbahce, are you kidding me? Last season, of course, against Sevilla. Southern the Champions League, of course, again there. But are you kidding me? Got them. Where can I go to? Ah, here. Wait. Where can I go to? Ah, here I can do it. What the fuck? So you can see that first knockout round. You can see, yeah, if you care and just looking at some German teams. Oh, against Porto, not bad. Schalke, of course, against Monaco. That's really decent. Then in the round of 16, Liverpool against Milan just smashed them. Schalke unfortunately out of the year. Chelsea actually was here winning. Fenerbahce did. I don't see even Fenerbahce. How they win? I don't really understand this, to be honest. But when Fenerbahce was in here, quarterfinals. I think the finals are still not done. So a few things. Okay, cool. Okay, Leicester City maybe winning the thing, semifinals. Yeah, I think we are in the semi. We are not even close to the end of it. So something I definitely have to check maybe on a later point. But you can see that at the moment Liverpool will be in the final, and there are four teams and three of them are English, so they're not bad. But last season actually Fenerbahce did win. That's quite crazy. Let's see. Against Manchester United as well in the final. What the hell? Let's go to Champions League. And that's the thing I saw. That Manchester City won the Champions League last season. Against Juve in the final. And then I don't understand. So they were amazing last season. They even won the Champions League. What happened to Pep afterwards? And this season, and this episode, oh yeah, and this season, well, I'm talking some shit. We have in the semifinals, yeah, English teams are doing amazing. This is why they got in front of the Bundesliga. So four teams in the semifinals of the EuroLeague, three English teams, and here again four. And again, you can see that there are definitely a full English EuroLeague final and a full English Champions League final. This is why Man United winning against Arsenal. So in Football Manager, English teams are doing amazing. Not sure why. Last season an English team won, this team it will be again. Last season, and this season again, there's a EuroLeague team, or an English team will win the EuroLeague. I don't understand. Some teams you would normally not see. I mean, Iran, would you see them in the World Cup? Denmark, maybe? Jamaica? Ghana? Yeah, okay. So this is kind of okay. Germany, of course, in the league, of course. Shitty group, yeah, fairly shitty, yeah, it's actually a decent group. And then you have in one group Spain, Germany, Costa Rica, and Chile. That's stupid. Congo, what are they doing here? England with France, okay. In China, Greece, Italy, Japan, again. Japan, it's crazy. Slovakia, what are they doing? So some groups don't make sense. But yeah, I think this is everything of these things really too important. The next thing I want to talk about is, I talked about that already two or three episodes ago. What if, because I got some decent offers, what if there is an amazing offer from a very decent team? And I got some offers from National League teams and stuff. I always declined the interviews because I don't care about it. But I got some offers from SkyBet League 2 teams. And I would do it. I myself was thinking I will do it. Of course, I mean, in the end, this is not a series of just being at Gloucester City all the time. In the end, I would love to maybe train Schalke at some point or whatever. I would love to. I'm basically the mentor there, and I want to go to different teams, the better teams, have more possibilities. Also, that teams who can offer me the basically that I can make the new or the next step, get the next. I forgot the name. Okay, I can check what it's called. I'm not sure how I can do it, but the next license, basically, what I want to do. And they don't have the money to do it. And I will just tell you about the teams I got offers from the League 2. I got an offer from Yelvertown. But Yelvertown at that point was 23rd, and as you can see, it's really close. I don't know why it's 22nd, it's not going down. So they were basically going down at that point. It seems like they actually had a quite decent form recently. Yeah, they actually got a decent form, but here they were. It really looked like they would go down. So this is why I declined that offer. I got an offer for Luton Town that was basically the same thing. So I also think they had quite a decent form in the end. Not really, actually. They had just 3 and CSO. Also declined these. So basically, from these two teams, I declined. Carlisle gave me an offer, as well as, I think, Plymouth. And I think that's it, basically. I think Plymouth gave me an option for an interview, as well as Carlisle, and I attended. And both teams were very interested, or were kind of interested for the interview, were really interested after the interview, but both teams, of course, decided against me. And I was thinking about all the time, would I do it? And you can definitely tell me in the comments if you would like me to do it, but I think I would have to. I think if somebody offers me the step to professional football, I have to do it, and I will do it. So if there is a decent offer now in the start of the season, because I got a lot of offers in the end of the season, where many teams, of course, especially going down, and I wasn't sure, and I first want to do Gloucester, but if I get an offer in the next few weeks, or 1-3 months, I'm very sure that I will attend, and hopefully will get the job. So the world ranking, Argentina is still first place. Germany used a 7th place, that's crazy. England up to 5th place. So a few things changed here, actually, to be honest. The three biggest major clubs are still from Spain. Top players is Messi and Neuer in front of somebody. So Messi, of course, it's crazy. Doing not too amazing, to be honest. 11 goals and 12 assists is extremely bad for that guy. 5 goals and 5 assists in the Champions League is okay. So he's doing quite bad. Let's have a look at Ronaldo. Ronaldo is also not doing really good. So both players are doing quite bad, to be honest. Ronaldo, of course, for the fee, so he will end his career at some point. Pogba is for that. He is doing amazing. Neuer, look at some of these players are just crazy. And of course, I would love to have some of these players in my team or at some point. You can see that financial-wise, Arsenal is still number one, but Tottenham is really close. Normally, it's always Arsenal and Man United. Tottenham is just behind them. So English teams, of course, financial-wise, because of the money they get. And then you have the teams who just perform the best, like Real Madrid, Barcelona, Bayern, PSG, or stuff. German teams are doing quite decent, way better than, for example, Italian, as well as Spanish teams. You just have Real Barca here, but already Bayern, Dortmund, Leverkusen, then Atletico here, then Schalke, Leipzig. So decent, I would say. So yet the biggest transfer was Vitolo to Real Madrid in the January transfer window. There aren't really big deals. Yeah, Brahimi to Giancarlo Evergrande, of course. But that's quite disappointing, to be honest, that the big deals... Okay, Felipe Coutinho to PSG is at the moment actually the biggest deal. PSG signed in June. No? They signed I don't know this guy. Goulam, Costa and Coutinho. So PSG is just signing everybody. And oh, here we have the biggest deal. Antoine Griezmann gone actually to City. 57 million to 70. So that's biggest deal yet. Some other big deals. So English teams are signing. I mean, the four biggest deals all to English teams. 75 million could it be for Dybala. So yet Griezmann basically. That's not too big. Real Madrid signed Costa. Not bad. Go. Like I said, gone to Leverkusen. What the fuck? Marino, Bayern signed another Dortmund player. Okay. Interesting. Here's nothing big anymore. I will then only have a look if Schalke did something crazy. So you see Lamela gone to Liverpool, of course. Leicester signed some players. Bayern signed a player. Not too important, to be honest. Tottenham actually the second highest attendance in the whole world. That's crazy. Yeah, I think that's basically all of that. Let's go to the last thing is what Schalke did actually, because it's just the most interesting thing for me. So the players they signed is basically, I think, the main thing we can really have a look at. So let's see. What transfers? Last season they just loaned out Wellenreuther, Kehrer, as well as Ruiz and Doom. Sort Ushida, that's okay. Chef, with a loan fee. Okay, don't know why they loaned him out, and a guy I don't know about, to be honest. And in this season, they signed Colin Planka, that's good. They signed Benderlab, that's also decent. Loaned out Ünal, who is playing actually amazing for them. So very good. But unfortunately just loaned out Drama and Bamba, of course, is still there. Bartstuber on the free, that's amazing. They loaned out Munir from Barcelona, okay, cool. A player I don't know about, Senior. Okay, don't know anything about the youngster as well as... Oh, they signed some youngsters, I really like that. This dude seems quite decent, actually. Don't know about that guy, and Tuck, okay. And Naldo retired, Rita retired as well as Doom, Aogo on a free transfer, who is now at, of course, Hamburg again. By the way, some unimportant players, Mangala on a free transfer, who, but somehow it happened to him, he's not a footballer anymore, seems like. Hinterla is left, actually. Not really a huge surprise, to be honest, but yeah, it will save some wage. London Ruiz, Platte, Kera, Krüger, Wellenreuther again. Wellenreuther should be improving a lot, to be honest. He's playing a lot. Schöpf again. Why are they loaning out Schöpf? He should play. Nübel, Aftichai. Yeah. Naldo is now an assistant manager, and I think he's available. I think he has no job. So should I actually try to get Naldo? I mean, of course, he's not interested, but that's something I really would like to do. To get Naldo. Sasha Doom is just free transfer. To get Naldo as an assist manager would be amazing. Guys, I think that's basically all I wanted to tell you. I told you what I think about the season, what I want to do next season, what I want to do before it. I told you that I might leave this club, if so, of course, I would tell you. I told you the transfer wise. I told you who won the Champions League, Euro League, and all the other leagues. Champions League, Euro League, of course, I will have a look in the next episodes. Told you the biggest transfers. I think I showed you everything I really wanted to show you. I want to have a quick look if Zlatan is still playing. I think that's the last thing I will have a look at. If not, then what is he doing? Zlatan still playing. But yeah, he's 36 now, so he's getting down. Finishing at 16, you have to be kidding me. How is he just finishing 16? I forgot, of course, one thing, which is the award. So the FIFA Ballon d'Or actually gone to Messi in front of Neymar at... That's... What? Messi won 3 times more at Özil. What? Are you kidding me? World FIFA World Player of the Year, the same thing. World Player, World Team of the Year is Neuer, Lahm, Marquinhos, Laporte, Alaba, Rodriguez, Di Maria, Dybala, Neymar, Messi. So Ronaldo is completely out of everything. And this is the last thing I wanted to check. Who scored the most goals? You can see the best goal scorer at the moment is actually Harry Kane, scoring 34 goals for Tottenham. Not bad. In the Champions League, 17 goals in 12 games. And then we go in. Suarez, Falcao, okay. Ronaldo, Belotti. I mean, Ronaldo scores a lot of goals. Why is he... Okay, I don't understand, to be honest. Leverkusen now has Javier Hernandez and Lacazette next to each other. That's just OP. Schalke is best goal. I want to see if there's Schalke anywhere here. Ünal with 18. Guys, I hope you enjoyed this episode. If so, please smash the like button. Tomorrow I will continue with Schalke. And yeah, I just wanted to make this episode so I can continue with this because I really want to. If something happens, so of course I will show you after. If I don't leave the club, then I think the next episode I will do if I'm like a few games into season 3. And then again, as long as I'm just in this league, I will not do that many episodes per season. I will just make something like after a few games and a mid-season episode and then a post-season episode. Guys, I hope you enjoyed this. If so, please smash the like button. I will see you tomorrow with Schalke. I'm repeating myself too often now, but you know me already. Have an amazing day, guys, and bye.